What are the requirements of being a Mardi Gras Indian?
In order to be an Indian, you have to sew. That's the first requirement.
You have to sew. We always stress that you have to sew. If you sew it and you can carry it, you can wear it.
And you have to do your own beading, your own sequence work, your own rhinestone work, whatever it is that you use to sew with, you have to do it.
Last year, I calculated it took me 10 and a half months to do my whole suit. We try to finish sewing with needle and thread at least 14 to 21 days before Mardi Gras. Because it takes us at least 7 to 14 days to hook our suits up. And that's with the cold glue, the hot glue, feathers, and everything like that.
It's not a costume. A costume is something you can just throw together in a few minutes. I mean, at least I can. Yeah, I can take a sheet and cut holes out the eyes to make eyes for a ghost costume. But these are actual suits that we're building and constructing, and we take hours and hours to construct these suits. But it doesn't take as long to make in Armani suit or a polo shirt or Versace tuxedo, what have you. These suits actually take months. We're not only artists. We have art that just can't be duplicated, not even by ourselves. I mean, once it's done, and nobody else could ever do it the exact same way.
One of my fans asked me how many beads I have on. I said, I think I counted correctly. It was 4,000,001. The nines that you was talking about, all those, yeah, those things I pretty much do myself.
It's like the fashion models, the runway models. I mean, everybody's lined up waiting to see us strut our stuff, show our suits off. You know, what do we have new for the year 2020?
Last year I wore vest, that was extra. I wore collar, that was extra. I sold the derby. That was extra. We the only ones who actually do a hat with all beads and stones.
As I'm sewing, things change. Things have to be altered. When I put it together, that's what I see. When I'm working, it just comes to me. I tend to think that it just depends on the way you're feeling. We have Black Mexican Indians that not only sew about Native Americans, they also sew about everyday life.
You might have pictures of 5 or 6 Indians with 3 or 4 horses, and it's on a field next to a water stream, and they have trees and birds flying and animals on the ground. So now you got to sew all of that, and you really got to put detail in it to make it look like what it's supposed to look like. So when the outside person sees it, they know exactly what they see.
This is a very intense form of competition. These guys are real men. They have families. And they're competing to see who's the prettiest.
When I see you, you might hear me say, I'm Wild Walker Nelly and I'm going to kill you dead. But what I mean when I say that is I'm going to kill you dead with the needle and thread.
The suits are pretty with the feathers and the different ruffles and lace. And of course, with the craft of the bead work, I mean, it's amazing. But it is about who's put down the most beads, who's done the most stonework, who's been the most creative as far as putting those suits together, because you have a lot of different styles and a lot of different materials.
You gotta win the Grammy. You have to win the Indian Grammy. That's what I always say. I wanna look the best. That's how our chief was raised. That's how he taught us. And that's how we're gonna come up. We have to look the best.
The first person that you're competing with is yourself, is trying to outdo the last suit. And if I beat the last suit, then I'm walking on cloud 9. Yeah, I can't be touched. When you look into that other person's eyes and they look into your eyes, you know who's the prettiest. Yeah, you know it and they know it.